Hi, I'm Paula Welander. I am a microbiologist and I study microbial lipid biomarkers. I also study how these molecules can inform us about ancient life and how life has evolved and eventually inform us about life on other planets. And this is my first graduating student.
Hi, I'm Marisa Mayer and I study lipid biomarkers in hot spring microbes. I just accepted a really exciting opportunity at NASA Ames Research Center to do postdoctoral research on lipid biomarkers in hot springs in astrobiology settings.
The core of astrobiology is that we are trying to understand whether there is life out there in the universe besides our own.
I am really excited about Mars in particular, but you know, the search for life on any other planetary world to me is just an amazing step we can take as humans right now and as scientists.
In order for us to be able to study that, and that involves all kinds of different fields of science, right? You have people that study exoplanets and they're trying to get, you know, the astronomy and all these wonderful things. But we also want to understand how life evolved, and there's only one instance where we know where life has arisen and evolved and that we can study, and that's on our planet. And we can study it in the past using the geologic record, and we can also study it in the lab using, you know, evolution studies and studies like the ones that we do. And one of the things that is, you know, our work is relevant is showing us what is life capable of making that can be preserved. And could we find these molecules or these kinds of different molecules on different planets? And how are these made and can we interpret them? We're microbiologists and we study microbes that are alive today that we can grow in the lab that produce these molecules. And we ask questions like, how do they make this molecule? Why do they make this molecule? Why is this molecule important? And the idea is that if you can understand in the lab when a microbe is making it, say like when this organism is stressed because temperature is too high, then you see it in the rock record, then can you ask the question, oh, is this indicative of this type of microbe? And is it also indicative of an environment that was really hot, like a hot spring or something like that? So you can make connections between what we see today and potentially what we're seeing in the rock record.
I am a little bit unique in the Welander lab in that I do field work. I get to go out to national parks and sample with them and go to hot springs actually out in the environment. These hot springs are, you know, not really for human enjoyment, so it's not like taking a bath. They're super acidic, and the ones I study aren't very high temperature, but others that I've seen and been around are, you know, really high temperature, really acidic, and so they're dangerous. So it's cool, you have to show a lot of respect to them. I really see what I study in the hot springs can link to certain deposits that are available in the fossilized rocks of Mars. Similar to how we have fossil evidence on Earth from really early ancient times that match hot spring environments, and that's why people are so excited about studying them as like an origin of life thing.
And I think the most important about the work we do are the people that are involved. We are people that are really curious and interested in a lot of different aspects of whether it be astrobiology or geobiology or microbes or planets. You know, none of this gets done without the people who work with me, who work for me, and the people who support me, and you know, all of us working together as a community. And so I think, you know, being able to be a molecular microbiologist that can jump into the field of geobiology and astrobiology and, you know, be able to come in and say, I don't know half of what you all are talking about, and they can come to me and say, I don't understand what you're doing, but we have these conversations, really has exemplified to me what interdisciplinary research is and what is needed, and it's communication and understanding and humility that you don't know everything and that we're all here trying to figure out the same questions from different angles, and that there's a lot of value in everything that we do together.